In this video, I'll be explaining basic anatomy of latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi is one of shoulder muscles. Let's look at its origin and insertion first. Its origin is about here, very wide origin. The first part is here. I just make a beige tape. One of its origins is the spinous process of thoracic spine, especially T7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So T7 through T12. This is one of origins. Then, you see, it kind of attaches on the scapula. It originates from inferior angle of scapula. So, spinous process of thoracic spine and inferior angle of scapula. So we have more. You see this tape? This tape is also latissimus dorsi. Actually, there's fascia on your back, which is called thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia covers your low back like this, very broad fascia. So this part of fiber actually attaches on the thoracolumbar fascia. The last part, this part is iliac crest, especially posterior side of iliac crest. And we have more origins. It originates from rib cage, especially rib 9, 10, 11, 12. So it attaches on rib cage as well. We have a lot of origins, right? Spinous process of T7 through T12, inferior angle of scapula, thoracolumbar fascia, posterior part of iliac crest, then rib 9, 10, 11, 12. That's a lot of origin, right? Latissimus dorsi is the only muscle which originates from your core, then go to humerus. This is only one muscle, starts from pelvis, lumbar, or spines, then attaches on humerus. This is very rare muscle. And what is its insertion? Insertion is on the humerus, but it's on the front side. Remember, its origins were back side, but insertion is on the front side. Typically, this place is called the groove of lesser tubercle. So basically, it attaches on the anterior part of humerus. This is important. And you see kind of, this tape is kind of twisted. You see this kind of wrinkles? I did it on purposely. I will explain why. So let's go to the function of latissimus dorsi. The latissimus dorsi is the strongest shoulder extensor. It is strongly extends your shoulder. Extension of shoulder is you pull arm backward. You see these tapes slack when I move shoulder. That means in reality, muscle contracts. Muscle contraction means the fibers shortens. So in this case, as I move shoulder backward, tapes slack. That means it's contraction. Anyway, shoulder extension, and it can do more. The one of the function is adduction of shoulder. Adduction is kind of you close arm this way. So adduction, this way, close your armpit. One more movement, which is internal rotation of shoulder joint. Internal rotation, internal rotation. Why is that? Because latissimus dorsi originates from backside. Why does it do internal rotation? Because it inserts in front of humerus. You see, the direction is this way. It kind of goes anteriorly. Then if muscle pulls arm this way, it makes internal rotation. And I have to talk about one more thing. I said there is kind of a twisting part on latissimus dorsi here. Why? Because of this twisting, the latissimus dorsi can exert more power. As I said, this is very strong shoulder extensor or shoulder adductor. Because it has to exert a lot of power, this kind of spiral structure can exert more power compared to just linear direction. So this kind of spiral part is very, very important. Then I'd like to talk about the connection with latissimus dorsi on the core area. As I said, latissimus dorsi originates from thoracolumbar fascia. Actually, thoracolumbar fascia has many connections with core muscle, especially transverse abdominis here. Transverse abdominis is the deepest core muscle. It is very important to stabilize your lumbar and ribcage and pelvic girdle. So, transverse abdominis attaches on the thoracolumbar fascia as well. Latissimus dorsi attaches on thoracolumbar fascia. Then it has connection with transverse abdominis. What does it mean? So if you can use latissimus dorsi very well, this kind of contraction can go to transverse abdominis. So if you can use latissimus dorsi well, you can stimulate transverse abdominis very well. This is very important, especially for sports. If you can use your back muscle, your core stabilizes very, very well. So this is one of the connections with latissimus dorsi. Let me explain one more connection. There's a very strong hip muscle here, gluteus maximus. Remember, the direction of fiber is this way, right? Latissimus dorsi's direction is this way. Then the other side of gluteus maximus fiber goes this way, right? So it's like the direction matches for contralateral side. Contralateral means the other side. So this is right side of gluteus maximus and left side of latissimus dorsi kind of match. So there is connection for contralateral side via what? Via thoracolumbar fascia. So thoracolumbar fascia is very important for core connection or lower body, upper body connection. I'd like to repeat again. Latissimus dorsi is the only muscle which originates from core and attaches on humerus. So that's why latissimus dorsi has many interesting connections with core muscle and lower body muscle. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of latissimus dorsi. Its origin, insertion, function. Then on the second part, I explained the fascial connection with latissimus dorsi. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.